this game was probably our best performance ever. They were the best team in Europe. They were the ones that we were measuring ourselves against.
Well, I wasn't actually playing. I was in the stands watching. I'd got injured.
Knocked it towards Gary Neville inside the Juventus penalty area. Cole trying to make it his.
So many of the team played well that night. But I think the thing that sticks in everyone's mind is Keane getting booked.
And now what's the referee going to do? It's a yellow card.
It was just a mistimed tackle, and as soon as he did it, I thought, oh no, he's going to book him.
He will not play in the Champions League final this season.
Some players go under, some players think, you know, I'm not getting in the final and start sulking, look, you know, that's not Keane.
Roy, after 20-something minutes, knew he wasn't going to play in the final, but it wasn't going to stop him from playing his best game ever for Manchester United.
You know, never mind I'm missing the final, I'm going to make sure that this team goes through to the final. And the way he played that night, I think it was one of the probably great performances I've ever seen.
The importance of the occasion, getting to the final, put his suspension right in another field altogether. It was never going to be an issue. He was going to make sure we got to the final.
The first goal in that game was the all-important goal, and it was a typical Keane goal, just arriving late and headed it into the net, and you just think to yourself, he was unbelievable that night, to be honest with you.
The whole team played well, don't get me wrong, it wasn't a one-man show by any manner of means, but he was the man, the pivotal man, in terms of changing the game around for us.
He literally went from strength to strength in the game, and that's why we got through to that final, because we had someone like that fighting, and that's the sort of leadership you need in a team.
But it was a night of different emotions for everyone. You know, some were elated to get there, but some were saying, oh, I haven't got Roy, I haven't got Paul.
It's likely that, you know, you knew that two teammates were happy that they got, you know, they got to the final, but they weren't going to be part of it.
Manchester United's first ever win on Italian soil takes them back to the final.
We're all celebrating, we're all, you know, out on the pitch, then we walk in, and the first person I see when I walked in was Keane, you know, sat down on the bench, and to be honest, you know, he looked devastated, and, you know, rightly so.
There was a, how would you put it, was it a distance from a normal elation of a triumph like that. I don't think it would have been the final and it would have been for Roy.
You never realise it at the time because you're part of it, but you look back in years to come and you'll think what an amazing performance it was by him, especially under the duress of knowing that he was going to miss the final.
It took a big effort from everyone at the club. And it embarrasses me when people say that, you know, Roy, you've gone to the final, you're going to miss out and stuff. Just think if I played on my own, I would have got to the final. No chance. It was a good team effort. Throughout the whole campaign, yeah, I managed to score in Juventus. Just doing my job, you know.